I think we talked about the blockchain, we talked about DeFi, we talked about metaverse. So now your story to talk about how exactly it will look like in real life.
Hey, good afternoon, everyone. Hi, I'm Somnath, and thanks for giving me this opportunity to bring some magic in terms of a solution. That's what we call Genie, right? So, Shantanu, please proceed forward. Shantanu, please proceed forward. Yeah. So, folks, you see, in today's consumers, we tried studying their behavior a little bit in terms of certain parameters. Now, we understand that today's consumers, let's say millennials, Gen Zs, Gen X, all of them are living in the moment. Now, when you live in the moment, the basic philosophy of life is that you live in the moment, you buy in the moment, correct? And we call buying in the moment as impulse purchases. So if you look at it, even different statistics corroborate the fact. Impulse buying accounts for 40 to 80%, 52% consumers will take advantage given there is a sales promotion over a full price pay, right? 52% of the millennials are more likely to go for an impulse purchase as compared to their older generations. And then within premise print ad, that means you tend to see standees, you tend to see tent cards, posters within, let's say, a food court or within a retail space of an exclusive showroom. And those things, those kind of advertisements or marketing is termed as print ads, right? Within premise. So that is roughly around $1.5 billion plus a whooping big market just for retail, travel, and hospitality. Think about other industries getting added to the mix, and this figure goes up. So everything looks fine. What is the problem area? So there is but a concern area. The concern area is that within premise print ad segment, which is $1 billion plus market, that spend is going out of the enterprises, proceed on to the next, is giving perhaps the lowest ROI, right? And why the lowest ROI? That's because there is no proper call to action. Example, you look at a burger picture. And what do I, as a marketer, expect? That you tend to look at that picture and then you tend to get hungry and then you go and buy. This is not a good way of doing things because I'm leaving entire thing as a variable, as an unknown onto you, right? I need to do something very positive to get you converted from your purchase intent to the actual purchase, right? So somebody, enterprises tried doing that with QR codes, but the problem with QR codes as it came apparent is that QR codes can be very easily mutilated because they are nothing but diagrams. They are nothing but coded diagrams. If I scratch a pen on that, if I give a different color on that, then you would not be able to decipher that diagram, which is encrypted. Point number one. Point number two is that they tend to, so any wrinkles, folds, destroy them. Different camera settings of different phones finds it difficult to focus depending upon ambient light and the distance between your camera or you and that particular poster, right? So in essence, what is happening is there is no deeper guest engagement. I need to engage you in that product. I need to make you feel interested in that product. And then I need to give a call to action for you to exactly go and do something on that. Then only I'm paving a way to bring that ROI to the table. Proceed on to the next. So we studied the generation next consumers on their loyalty points. Okay. So I have taken the liberty of using that word purchase basket. Generally, we go by the term market basket analysis, right? So new generation consumers use loyalty points, but they use it very, very contextually across their purchase basket. What does it mean? It means that, let's say my purchase basket has got a t-shirt, has got a pair of shoes, has got some weight training or fitness materials and a pen. I would like to use loyalty across all this. The traditional way was I would be using loyalty points for my high value purchase or only for the t-shirt or t-shirts point for the t-shirt. That is breaking the barriers. They are saying we live in the moment. We need to be able to use this collection of points across the pot, not just for a specific product on the pot. So 75% consumers are more likely to purchase from brands who has got apps. That means they are giving them a very dedicated environment. 95% of the loyalty program members prefer newer technologies to be engaged. Okay. And we all know that it is easy for any marketer to sell to consumers who are your existing consumers. Because the cost of, first, there is a cost of acquisition of new customers, and you really do not know how those new customers is going to respond back to your marketing stimuli, correct? But there is a problem. And the concern area is 85% of these loyalty points go unspent. Have you noticed your maybe HDFC, Citibank, all these card points sometimes go lapse? You really are not much aware of it. Why is it happening that way? So we poked into that matter. We tried going into the weeds of that matter. And we saw that loyalty points are going wasted because of limited scope of applicability. That means you are getting a chance to use that point on a specific product, or dictated by that enterprise on its own given choice of products, which you may not like. For example, let's say you have got some Etihad points. Either you use purchasing an Etihad ticket, or you go to Etihad's e-commerce portal and look at a pen drive and think, I don't need a pen drive. Maybe I need a screw set. Maybe the screw set is not there in the inventory. Second point is instant gratification. What does it mean? You went for a movie, right? And you got some points. You came out and you are trying to catch up with your friends, planning that, hey, let's go to the nearby eatery. But then you cannot expend those points of the movie in the eatery, perhaps, correct? You are restricted to buy another ticket for another movie and then expend that point that you have accumulated today while watching that movie and buying tickets, right? And there is actually no exchange platform, just like stocks, for loyalty points. There is no loyalty point exchange platform, barring a few which are very tailor-made, co-branded loyalty programs, very restricted environments like, let's say, Alliance Partners or, maybe Gold Point Plus in US, right? So if there is not a technology services company or a product company who has come up with a platform saying, hey, you come here, you register yourself as a merchant, and boom, you have got access to other merchants' customer base in terms of exchanging the points. So proceed on. Then we understood that for today's consumers, delivery and timely delivery to your address or to your desired address is the key. The CEP market, as we call it, the courier, express, and parcel market, is a whopping $360+ billion market in 2022, and it's increasing in leaps and bounds. And 41% customers ranked say that reliable and faster delivery is what they're looking. That is the top of their consideration when they're going for shopping. And the three major challenges is that, for CEP market, the last mile delivery is a big challenge. So your 90% of the transportation would be smooth, but the last mile in the destination country would be problematic. And this market is very, very fragmented. Lots of franchises, small entities, so actual diffusion of technology to bind them together on a single information exchange kind of a scenario is missing. Only big players like, let's say, FedEx or DHL are having robust technologies. If you look at the smaller entities in the market or the fragmented franchised entities in the market, the diffusion has not happened much. Proceed on. So lack of seamless information exchange, lack of digitization, except for big players, and the absence of any uniform technology platform is what is inhibiting the ability to deliver for an on-the-go purchase instant, right? Last but not the least, today's consumers are extremely data sensitive. Look at that. 40% of your traffic is being tracked by Google alone, 15% of the web traffic by Twitter, and 4% by Microsoft. Right. It's and then 53% of online users are more concerned about their internet privacy. 81% respondents feels helpless. They think that, we are not in control of the data. We cannot do anything. And 71% are trying to do something here and there by getting some ad and spam blockers and all whatnot. Right. And in all of the previous slides, you saw there is one concern area. But here, the whole aspect is a concern area. Right. So proceed on. So we thought, how to engage my consumers for all these in-premise marketing props, convert their purchase intent in their head into actual purchase, help them use their loyalty very seamlessly, pay effortlessly, right? And deliver their purchases to the desired address all while making sure that their data is in safe hands while they are on the go. Because today's generation, again, they prefer living in the moment, right? On the flow, with the flow, right? So we thought, how about trying to reimagine this customer experience a little differently? Go ahead. So we thought, how about making the entire in-premise marketing stimulus to be responded with a tap? So tap and do anything that you want, right? Maybe a loyalty exchange platform to facilitate them use points from one merchant to another, right? Giving them an end-to-end digital, you know, platform that can help them handle documentation, handle the paperwork, handle, you know, payment reconciliation, so that seamlessly the purchase gets delivered to any corner of the globe. Let's say you are flying in a flight, looking at an in-flight magazine, trying to purchase something, but you do not generally purchase it because you have to get down at the destination address and then at the airport stand in a long queue and collect it. But let's say that is not there. Let's say you are sitting there in the airplane, choosing that, adding it to your cart and getting it shipped to Mumbai while you are traveling from Heathrow to Washington. How cool that can be, right? And then last but not the least, every time that you are doing this, your data is absolutely secure. Nobody can misuse it. So our proposition is engage on the go, purchase on the go, loyalty on the go, pay on the go, and deliver on the go. Quite a few tasks, isn't it? We cannot do it humanly. So we called Genie to the table. We named it as Genie on the go. Now there is a story behind this. Genie on the go is a platform where three solutions, which were conceived by three different teams across three points in the globe, not knowing that the other would ever exist, came through a collaboration and got stitched together. One is NTAP, which is helping you to engage and purchase on the go. One is Swap, which is allowing you to exchange your loyalty points meaningfully, backed by an AI engine, and then pay while you are on the go for the remaining amount. And then last but not the least, this Cargo Mind Hub, which is allowing you to deliver the merchandise on the go, let's say while you are traveling in a train or you are flying at 30,000 feet above sea level. These are some of the solution highlights of these component solutions. Now, the beauty of Genie on the go is that you can take Genie on the go, but you can even test it out with individual solutions, which are absolutely independently implementable solutions, having their own B2C component, having their own business to enterprise component for the management of those solutions. And together, but when you do it together in unison as a common platform like Genie, you bring more synergy and more value for your consumers, right? So, and that's with that digital tokenization. So for example, whenever you are giving an address, that address can be used by the third party with a token only once. They cannot misuse it. So they cannot sell that syndicated data to someone. And then suddenly you tend to get a lot of leaflets in that address and you have got no clue how this address went on to this particular merchant or that particular organization. You need not be bothered about that. So let's see Genie in the action. What I'll try to do is that all that concept that I've talked about, I will try to show you through a very quickly put prototype, a day in the life of a Melissa, who is a business executive, a busy working woman, independent, and she is trying to make a difference in the world. Let's see how Genie is helping her all throughout, right? So the backdrop is this. Melissa is traveling from Frankfurt to Boston, let's say on a business trip. She got a little delayed in Boston and she went inside the airport and she's gone through the frisking, the security check, and her head is heavy, all those meetings. She needs a coffee desperately, but she doesn't really know which way to go. She doesn't want to waste time. She saw a standee. So first she opened up the airport and she saw to her surprise that there's an MTAP feature and it is onboarded. It says that if you click on this to activate your app so that it can read the MTAP service tags. So she's there, she tapped on it and she got this and she's all set. Then she noticed the standee, right? Yeah, she noticed the standee where there's a Peruvian mocha, right where the frisking got done. She went ahead, got interested, tapped her phone. Immediately, the web app of the airport got invoked. The Peruvian mocha got added to the cart and she saw some of the other things that she might prefer. She didn't prefer that on that day because she just needed a coffee and she made a payment. Let's see how she makes a payment. Whoa, you see, swap opened up, and it already adjusted backed on its based on its AI driven engine the Emirates Sky Miles and the Marriott Bonvoy points, and she just needs to pay $1. So two and one, $3 got adjusted to that four. One needs to be paid. How cool can that be, right? And all this is happening because Swap is predicting this is the best ratio in which that those points can be combined. She got the order done. She viewed the map, and it tells her where she is and where's that store. So she exactly knows where to navigate without wasting much time. She went there and she said, this is my order number, and then proceed on. And she's the person who is saying, I have received my order. So nobody can fraudulently take it. She says, yes, I have gotten the order, and how satisfied you are. So you can put here anything that you want. For example, you can put a quick question, quick numbers, some emoticons, whatever you want. Then once she's there, she went through the boarding, sipping her coffee, and she got boarded to the airplane. She's well settled on the seat. But then she thinks, oops, I forgot to purchase the in-flight Wi-Fi. I need to catch up on my emails. And this is going to take a long haul flight, let's say 8 to 10 hours. So she finds this passenger safety card on the back pocket of the previous seat where there's an MTAP logo. She taps her phone. By this time, she's understanding what MTAP is, right? And then the INX Airlines native app opens up. The in-flight Wi-Fi gets added to the cart, and she's trying to pay for it. Again, Swap comes into picture and says, hey, you know what? You have got some Skyward miles and some Bonvoy points, and you can adjust $7 here. You just need to pay $1. So every time you are seeing that those points which could have gone under your nose are getting picked up by Swap, and it is presenting based on its your usage pattern that this is the best ratio in which these points can be combined, right? So that you can make meaningful purchase through it, right? And then she purchased the in-flight Wi-Fi, right? She's all happy because she can now catch up on her emails. She gets to, and we have incorporated this survey thing because generally what happens is that people tend to talk too much about bad experiences, but it is equally important for an enterprise to understand what are the good experiences. Then she's sitting there on the flight, all emails being caught up properly, but she's thinking that, oops, I have missed some near and dear ones, a birthday, right? And I should have purchased something and sent it across. Now, she went ahead and saw that in-flight magazine. Do you see that there's a difference? The in-flight magazine is a glossy magazine of certain pages, paper bound, which is kept in the back pocket of the previous seat. We say, change it this way. Just give one page, reduce the number of page, save the trees, save the aviation fuel, you know, reduce your carbon footprint. You just tap your phone there and entire magazine would be rendered on your handheld, because who doesn't have a handheld these days, right? Everybody is having a smart handheld, right? 99.99% of the passengers would be having that. So it is, and now that you are, you know, hooked onto the in-flight Wi-Fi, it does make all the sense that you tap your phone there and get the in-flight magazine rendered on your hand. Proceed on. You get the catalog, you select something that you wanted to purchase, added it to the cart. And then you see here a nifty feature. Would you like to get it shipped to a desired address? There comes the difference. So you add the address here, the default address from your wallet comes, and otherwise you could have added it and then proceeded on to pay. You end up paying again through Swap very meaningfully, and you are happy about it. Yeah, please go ahead and pay. Yeah, bye. And it is confirmed. So all we are trying to do is we are trying to put consumer right in front of me. And it is a guest-centric or consumer-centric approach that Genie is taking all the way, okay, bit by bit in your journey, at a day in your life or whatever, you know, and then helping you out in every step of the way to get an experience which is very, very seamless, right? Which is absolutely seamless, right? And which is less of friction, and which is very convenient, right? And which is very intuitive. So here I'll stop, and the floor is open for questions, I believe.